Yeah, this drama. Hi, you're watching Avenue X, where junkie and good storytelling shares her thoughts, knowledge, and occasional weird ideas on stories and how they're told. I'm going to try to make this my shortest, quickest ever review about any drama, so please bear with me. Legend of Haolan, aka The Story of Yanxi Palace version 2, is pretty much a self-plagiarizing attempt of recreating the previous drama's success in summer 2018. It went into production last October, so you can imagine why they did so. You have pretty much the same cast, doing almost the same roles as they did in Yanxi Palace, and the plot is so similar that you can literally watch it with Yanxi Palace interchangeably. The most distinctive character of this drama is every role is literally acting their lines and their plot, not their character. They'd be preaching time and time again of their core values repeatedly to the audience, literally spelling out what they're thinking. Doesn't matter if it's the main characters or the supporting roles, everyone is so flat in this drama that they're flatter than any animation characters I've ever seen. To stop you from noticing that, they've compacted the plot so densely that literally shit is going down in every moment, so that you're bombarded with those plots until your mind is completely numb from telling actually there's no logic of how things actually developed to a certain point. So this drama is literally all revelation, no setup. If you're thinking of watching this drama, my recommendation would be if you don't speak Chinese, then please don't watch it because it will be a waste of your time. You have to stare at the screen to see the subtitle and know what's going on. You'd be much better off using your time for any other thing such as meditation. If you do speak Chinese and you can just listen to it as a radio play, which is what I do, it's another perfect IKEA drama choice. I listen to it while I make my clay figures, I'm practicing at that, just so that the room is not dead quiet, and I can listen to it as a comedy and it's actually really funny. In terms of the looks of the drama, it may appear actually quite pretty on screen, but I see Japanese aesthetics, I see Korean historical kind of look, I see nothing Chinese. If you're interested in Warring States period, spring and autumn periods of China, this is not where you go and look for reference. Finally, before I go, I just like to say, since this drama is about the mother, the father, and the rumored father of the first emperor of China, if China ever had a version of Egypt's pharaoh's curse, it would be this dynasty and this emperor, considering his tomb is still filled with mercury and nobody can go in even till today, considering 2000 years ago they made terracotta soldiers. Yeah. Look at what happened to the neighbor drama that tries to screw up that part of the history. So that is my super fast, quickest ever review, impression, whatever, of a Chinese drama. I hope you have a good day. Thank you for watching. I'm UX. I'll see you in my next video. Meanwhile, live long and happy drama listening.